guys, it's Karen. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another video. Today we are meal prepping. Meal prepping has been so beneficial for me. Not only is it a time saver, it saves me money, and it just makes my life easier knowing what meals that I'm going to prepare for the week. Even if I do decide to like make something else or prepare something else, at least I have some like basic go-to meals that are already done for me, so I don't even have to think about it, especially when I am working or if I have like a lot of stuff going on. This just helps me out because it also prevents me from just like buying something or just, you know, not getting into good eating habits or not keeping good eating habits. This is what I use to plan out my meals. This will be in my Practically Plant-Based Guide. If you have already purchased the guide, then you should have either already gotten an update or you will get an update with these in here. But if you want a copy of these, then you can find those in my Practically Plant-Based Meal Prepping Guide. I will leave a link to that in the description box. But this is basically outlines for each week what meals that I'm planning on prepping. So there's a section for breakfast. I can list out all of my breakfast ideas, lunch, any dips or dressings. I like to do at least one or two dips or dressings to go on my salads and my wraps, my dinner options, and then also drinks. So this includes like juices, any special teas, smoothies that I'm going to prep, like all of that will go here in the drinks, and then my snacks as well. So these are like any items, like even if there's like nuts or seeds or something like that, that will go in the snack section. And then based upon the meals that I'm planning on prepping for the week, that's when I would start to prepare my grocery list. Now, this is also categorized as well, and it goes by the week, so you can put the date here. So it's got fruits, vegetables, nuts and seeds, spices and seasonings, herbs, dry goods, dairy alternatives, like this, like your yogurt, and if you like buy already made almond milk or any sort of plant milk, that will go in here. And then also how I have a space for household items as well. So based upon, again, based upon what I have already outlined in my meal organizer, that's when I would prepare my grocery list. So I would just check my fridge and my pantry to see what items I need in order to make the meals that I plan on prepping. This also prevents me from buying things that I already have in stock. So I always check my pantry, check my fridge, just to make sure that I already don't have those ingredients. And this is all that I buy. I bring this with me to the grocery store. So it's based upon what meals I'm prepping. I make my list based upon what I don't have and need to go shopping for. And again, this is what I take with me to the grocery store. It not only saves me time, but it's also a money saver as well. And again, if you want a copy of these are going to be in the Practically Plant-Based Meal Prepping Guide. And again, if you have already purchased the guide, no worries. You will get the updated guide that includes these lists. All right, let's jump into meal prepping. So for my breakfast option, I am making raw donuts, and this is actually a recipe that I've been experimenting with using some soaked buckwheats. I've really been enjoying working with soaked buckwheats. I made those in my last video, in the pizza crust video, and I really like what you can do with buckwheat, and it's also gluten-free, it's protein-rich, really, really good. So I'm just making, this is like a basic raw donut. Now I decided to use kind of like a Ziploc bag to scoop all of my donut batter in, and I got these silicone molds from Amazon. If you're interested in those, I will leave a link to them in the description box, but they are also good for the oven as well. I haven't tried it in the oven yet, but it's supposed to be oven safe. Of course, it's safer in the dehydrator, which is what I'm going to use with them. Thank you.
So I'm going to take these and place them in my dehydrator just until they are fully dried and they hold that donut shape, as you can see here. And not bad, especially for my first time. Like, these look so good. Now for my icing, I decided to play around with coconut manna. If you're not familiar with coconut manna, it's just coconut puree or the meat of the coconut. And I'm using some blue spirulina. I've been obsessed with blue spirulina lately. I just like turning things blue. But I am gonna experiment with some other types of icing for these donuts. But this is what we are using today, which works out perfectly. So I'm just gonna dip each donut into the icing, as you can see here. And I really like how these turned out. You can add additional toppings on here. I just added a few coconut flakes. So next up, my dressing. I'm going to make a hemp seed herb dressing. These are actually things that I use on, already have on hand. That's why I say always check your pantry, because you never know. You can have like an entire meal in your pantry and not even realize it. So don't be so quick to like run to the grocery store and buy additional ingredients. Try to work with what you have, because you can definitely create something absolutely delicious from things that you already have. This turned out so creamy and delicious. Like I said, I like to have at least one or two dressings to kind of get me through the week, just because it saves time. Again, I can put these on my salads, I can put them on wraps, dips, so many things that you can do with it. So another option I'm making is some lentil patties. I like making veggie patties or burger patties because they are great for meal prepping. You can have these with lunch, you can have them for dinner, put them on wraps, make a sandwich out of it. So much you can do with it. And they are also easy to freeze, so they last a really long time. I like to make them in batches and freeze some of them. They come in so handy. Lentils are also very high in protein, so it's just a good, quick, easy way to get your protein in. Now I am adding in some fresh herbs, some fresh parsley, which I really think paired well with these. And another thing is, you can make the patties as big or as small as you like. I want a kind of little nugget mini size patties, but again, if you want like a big giant burger, you can definitely do that. And my patties, they stuck together really well, so I'm just going to load those up on my baking tray. And these will go right in the oven until they turn out nice, golden, and brown like this. And you can serve these with some tahini dipping sauce like I did, or again, you can put them on wraps, salads, like along some sauteed veggies even. There's so much you can do with these, and they're so delicious and high in protein. I hope that you guys enjoyed these high protein rich meal prep videos. Again, if you have not already gotten the Practically Plant-Based Guide, check the link in the description box. Thank you guys again for watching this video, and I will see you on the next one. Later.